Because recently I'm very much into building things, I've decided that for a good balance I need to unbuild something from time to time. I have found this old microwave left by someone lying in the street and decided to give it an inspection and find out what useful components, if any, I could salvage out of it. Let the destruction begin. My first step was to figure out how to remove the metal case in order to get access to the internal elements. Inside you can see that your typical microwave is in fact very simple and consists of basically two areas, the electronics harness and the inside, where normal people put their food for it to warm up. After removing about a thousand of screws, I can see the first potentially useful thing, which is this rather plain bulb together with a matching housing. It works with 240 volts and it's not exactly of the energy efficient kind, but it should be good for testing some AC power in the future. But before that comes out, there are a couple more screws and the power supply module which keeps all the wires in place, making it slightly more difficult to disassemble. Majority of microwaves come with a fan which prevents the whole system from overheating. It also comes with a rather inefficient motor, but still can be used for a desk fan project, or worst case scenario, the nice looking coil from its windings can be of some use to someone. Now, the heart of a microwave is this big chunk of metal which is called the magnetron. Combined with electricity, it is used to emit some radioactive waves which heat up the food in the oven as a result. From what I've read on the internet, it's likely to contain some amount of beryllium, especially the older models, so I wouldn't advise doing anything with it other than disposing it along with your local regulations. Do not ever attempt neither scratching any of its ceramic elements nor opening it, not even mentioning trying to power it up. It's way too dangerous, trust me. It is worth noting that apart from the magnetron itself, there is one more dangerous element in most microwaves available. Talking about the high voltage capacitor, you can see it in the top left part of the microwave. It kind of resembles a tiny car exhaust. Do not ever attempt touching any of its terminals, as it can be still charged with at least few thousand volts, and it is capable of holding that charge even for weeks when unused. If you really need to touch it, make sure you discharge it in a safe manner first. There are cool projects that this can be used for, but for now let's leave it in a safe place and carry on digging. On the power supply circuit board, you can see a couple of useful components that can be retrieved. Some power resistors, capacitors, an inductor coil of sorts, an AC relay, some connectors and a fuse mount. These may come in handy if you're into building things. There's also this massive transformer. It's really heavy and as a rule of thumb, a transformer of unknown specs should not be reused, but its core could be used for an electromagnet project or something. Here's the light bulb with housing, then the fan and the rest of the harness. It does not come off too easily, but all it needs is a bit of patience. On the front panel we have some knobs and a timer switch with a bell, obviously used to measure your cooking time. It could be useful as well. Now, removing the bottom part exposes what is a synchronous motor, which is designed for really slow rotational movement, about 4 rotations per minute in this case, but it strongly depends on the particular motor. It can also be reused as a generator, although it's not of great quality. The gears inside of it, which make it turn really slow, are likely to be made of plastic, which is not ideal in terms of durability. But hey, it's 3 parts, so no complaining allowed. The door of the oven contains a sheet of glass. You can dispose it or keep it if you need a piece of solid, partially transparent glass. Now, the rest of what used to be your microwave will be just a steel cage. It can either go to the scrapyard or could make a good spaceship project. Who knows? So, to summarize, here you can see all the components that can be kept from an old microwave. I can already see a few interesting small projects, with some of them at least. Hope you enjoyed this quick video and found out something new today. Stay safe and until next time!